Cyberpunk 2020 was a 1988 tabletop role-playing game,
the second version of which was set in a fictional 2020. The game takes place in a dystopian future where multiculturalism has failed and America is, quote, divided by class, race, and economics. The main themes of the game pertain to futuristic transport, weaponry, and transhumanism. But it's the cultural and sociological tropes featured in the game that make some of its predictions eerily prescient. Again, to emphasize, this RPG was originally created 30 years ago, and in an updated 1994 rulebook, we find this stunningly pinpoint prophecy about life in 2020. Diversity and unity. It is now accepted among historical scholars that in the decades before the collapse, America suffered from the sickness of racism and cultural identity. Everyone wanted to be seen as special. Every group had to be equal to or preferably better than its neighbors and fought to protect its special rights. If anyone had something that someone else wanted, they were painted as racist, sexist, elitist, or worse. This divisive me-first attitude eventually tore the fabric of American culture apart and caused it to self-destruct in a fireball of competing ideologies, none of which truly recognized each other's validity. Diversity led inexorably to anarchy. Wow, I guess the designers of Cyberpunk 2020 must have been racists. Yeah, actually it was created by this based black dude. But anyone who has followed modernity's obsession with identity politics and the sanctification of victimhood as a form of special status exploited to impose political and cultural hegemony. That's a creepily prophetic observation, given that it was made nearly three decades ago. But that wasn't the only prediction that Cyberpunk 2020 got bang on the money. The game's 1988 rulebook predicted, quote, a Great Britain swamped by mass immigration, leading to streets almost explosively as dangerous as the United States. That kind of rings a bell.
A wave of stabbings have given London a higher murder rate than New York City.
Every 14 minutes, there's a knife crime across England and Wales.
Knife crime is at a near record high, with more than 40 blade offences every day in London.
If your child is involved in a gang and there's nowhere for him to hide, you take him back to Africa. You know, it's safer there than it is in London.
When you're a parent sending your child back, it's a risk you're taking, but unfortunately, some parents feel like it's also a risk leaving their kids in the streets of London.
Diversity is a strength.
The game also predicted the rise of the, quote, me-first worldview, which is now exemplified by exploding narcissism driven by social media addiction. The RPG also foresaw a future in which, quote, entertainment has become generic, and a conglomeration of TV networks emerged to deliver hundreds of channels that produce a product which is, quote, bland, mindless, and caters to the lowest possible denominator. That kind of rings a bell too. In a successful attempt to distract the population from the dystopia that surrounds them, in the game, the so-called media nets ensure that every apartment has access to this idiocracy-style mass entertainment. The game also predicted the decline of traditional media platforms, with old-fashioned newspapers and print magazines fading into oblivion. The original Cyberpunk game was inspired by a 1986 sci-fi novel called Hardwired. In Hardwired, and by extension Cyberpunk, ruthless corporations have created vast monopolies, have amassed more power than countries, and everyone is completely dependent on them. According to Cyberpunk's 1988 rulebook, in 2020, quote, dissenting opinions and independent productions are usually buried under an avalanche of media hype, or worse, co-opted or destroyed by the vicious competitive practices of the major media corps. That definitely reminds me of something. Just can't quite put my finger on it.
Imagine this for a second. One man with total control of billions of people's stolen data, all their secrets, their lives, their futures. I owe it all to Spectre. Spectre showed me that whoever controls the data controls the future.
But at least it's not that bad yet, right? We can still express dissenting opinions without being silenced by megacorps. At least when someone tried to post about Cyberpunk 2020 on Reddit under the title, in the original Cyberpunk 2020 rulebook, diversity was the downfall of America. The post wasn't immediately removed, right? Oh, It was immediately removed. A big Cyberpunk 2020 theme is augmentation of the body with cyber technology, which in turn causes an ensuing loss of humanity as the characters become more synthetic. Which was another adept example of prescient social commentary on our increasing addiction to smartphones and the wider body modification transhumanist movement.
The Stockholm subway system also has plans to modify their turnstiles so they can be opened with implanted chips. Over 3,500 Swedes now have microchips under their skin.
You got the chip?
According to the 1988 rulebook, quote, as each new technological enhancement slammed into place, a sort of cultural techno shock set in. In a 2006 update to the game called Cyberpunk 23X, corruption of the internet has made, quote, all data intangible and recent recorded history is in doubt. Again, this speaks to the contemporary lurch towards internet censorship and digital book burning, in addition to fears over fake news. This update also accurately predicted the rise of deepfake technology, misleading people about the nature of reality, and the power of memes to influence culture and society. Cyberpunk 2077, a new video game starring Keanu Reeves, based on the original RPG, is set to be released next year. In the game, the metropolis of Night City is divided up into six different regions. One is the domain of elitists, another of criminal gangs, and another of immigrants. In other words, diversity and integration appears to have failed. Segregation is a way of life. And nearly a year before the game is even released, we're already seeing a progressive backlash to Cyberpunk 2077. In this tweet, a leftist expresses his outrage at a certain level of disgust expressed by characters in the game to the sight of a heavily technologically augmented naked woman in a bathtub. Although the objective in the game is to rescue the woman, she is seen as profane, unclean, and not fully human because she is, quote, augmented too much. Given the hostile takeover of the video game industry by the cult of wokeness, as illustrated by the Gamergate controversy, if Cyberpunk 2077 remains true to the dystopian world depicted by its original creators, expect the cultural thought police to react to it with some decidedly frosty reviews.
It's absolutely crucial for us to stay in touch that you subscribe to my free newsletter right now at summit.news/newsletter. Link in description.